So in the right hand side corner, you can see the map of Europe here. We'll see the content first. What are the contents we have in this chapter? Starting with the introduction, we'll be discussing about the land and location of Europe, its political division, as well as we'll be discussing about the physical division of Europe. This is the political map of Europe, indicating with different colors, okay, to indicate different countries here. Now coming to next introduction. So Europe lies in the Asian, western part of Asia or Asia, and it is, or we can say, the sixth largest continent or the second smallest continent in the world. So Europe has an area of about 10.8 million square kilometers. This is the approximate area of Europe, 10.8 million square kilometers. So comparatively to other continents, it is smaller in size. So in spite of small size, Europe and the European people have left long and lasting effect on political, cultural and socio-economic history of the world. So it has a kind of significant impact on the political, cultural as well as socioeconomic part of the aspects, you can say. Coming to next, Europe was very powerful in the 17th and the 18th century. So by this time period, Europe could dominate the other world, okay. During this time, the Europe was very much powerful, so thereby it became the controller of the world within this century. Okay, now land and locations. We'll see the extension of Europe and the water bodies that surrounds the Europe, as well as the latitudinal and longitudinal extensions. So Europe lies entirely in the temperate zone. So you are very much familiar with this term, temperate zone, torrid zone, and the frigid zone, when you have studied the temperature belt of the world. So temperate zone lies in those latitude, or the temperate zone belongs to the latitude between about say 40 to 60 or to 65 degree. So this much of extension is considered as the temperate zone. Okay, now the latitudinal extension of Europe is 35 degree north and 72 degree north, and its longitudinal extension is 25 degree west and 65 degree east longitude. So the latitudinal extension will show the presence of the continent in which temperature belt, whether it is in the temperate zone or whether it is in the torrid zone. So it's very clear that the latitudinally this region lies in the temperate zone. And east-west extension, we have it extend in the western side as well as in the eastern side. So towards the west, Europe extend up to 25 degree, and towards the east it extend up to 65 degree. So maximum extension of Europe is in the eastern side. Okay, so the continuous landmass of Europe and Asia is also known as Eurasia. This is important. So what is Eurasia? So Eurasia is a continuous landmass between Asia and Europe. So this is why it is termed as Eurasia. And the physical features that separate the continent of Asia and Europe are Ural Mountain and the Caspian Sea. So remember these two physical features that separate Asia and Europe: Ural Mountain and Caspian Sea. Now there are some water bodies that surrounds the continent of the Europe. Although Europe is a peninsula surrounded by water on three sides, okay. So the major water bodies that surrounds the continent are the Arctic Ocean in the north, the Atlantic Ocean in the west, and the Mediterranean Sea and the Black Sea in the south. So remember these four important water bodies that surround in the three direction. Okay, Arctic Ocean in the north, the Atlantic in the western side, and the Mediterranean and the Black Sea in the south. Let's see in the map. Okay, You can see in the map here the water bodies that surrounds the continent of Europe. So this is your Arctic Ocean, this is Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea, as well as this is Caspian Sea. Okay, so these are the water bodies in the south. In the west we have Atlantic Ocean, in the north we have Arctic Ocean. Now coming to next, so a peninsula in itself, Europe is also made of few more peninsulas lying along the coast. So peninsula, Europe is peninsula itself. So as I already told you, what is peninsula? Peninsula is a landmass that is surrounded by water on three sides. Okay, like Deccan Plateau of India, or Deccan, the southern portion of India is a peninsula because it is surrounded by water on three sides: the Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, and the Indian Ocean. So similarly, here Europe is also a peninsula because it is surrounded by water on three sides. That's we have already discussed about this. Now the important peninsula, they are the Scandinavian Peninsula, the Iberian Peninsula, and the peninsula of Italy and Greece. These are the important peninsula of Europe: Scandinavian Peninsula, Iberian Peninsula, and the peninsula of Italy and Greece. Okay, coming to next, the political division of Europe. So as already discussed, Europe is a small continent, but it has almost of 50 sovereign states. Now what is sovereign states or sovereign nations? Sovereign states or a sovereign nation has power to rule over the citizen. They will be having a supreme power to rule over their citizen. Okay, it may be in a democratic form, or it may be in a monarchy form of government, ruled by the king, or maybe ruled by the elected government. So in this situation, the country will have a supreme power to rule over their citizen. It is not binded by any kind of laws. Okay, so about sovereign nations, you'll be learning about this in the previous in the later classes. If you go to the higher classes again, in the okay. Now coming to next, Europe is also the home to world smallest country, that is the Vatican City, which is in Rome, and the largest country, that is Russia. Okay, so it's important to remember the smallest country Vatican City, and the largest country Russia. Okay, it's important one. And the five tiny nations in Europe, they are San Marino, that is in Italy, Monaco in south coast of France, Andorra in Pyrenees, and Liechtenstein in Central Europe, and the Vatican in Rome. So these are the five important tiny nations in Europe. So this is important to note, five important tiny nations. Now the Western European countries include France, that the country that lies in the western part are France, UK, and Ireland. We can also see in this map here, the country that lies in the western part, they are especially France, okay, and even UK and Ireland, as well as Ireland here, United Kingdom here. So these are the countries that lie in the western part of Europe. Okay, coming to next, the west, okay, the Central European countries, especially Germany, Switzerland, Austria, Italy, Hungary, Czech Republic, Slovakia, and Poland. These are the countries that lies in the central part of Europe. We can also see in the map here. See the countries that lies in the central. Okay, so here the countries that belongs to Iberian Peninsula, especially they are Spain, Portugal, and Andorra. These are some of the samples of Iberian Peninsula, countries belongs to Iberian Peninsula. And the countries that belongs to Scandinavian countries, or also known as Nordic countries, they are Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Finland and Iceland. Okay, these are some of the examples of Scandinavian countries. You can also see this in the map here. You can see Sweden, Norway, Finland, okay, even Denmark is an example of Nordic countries or the Scandinavian countries. Okay, now coming to next, lowland countries are also known as Benelux countries. They are Belgium, the Netherlands and Luxembourg are the examples of lowland countries because their altitude is very low, or it is almost below the sea, not exactly below the sea level, but it is near to the sea level. Okay, this is why the this countries are known as the Benelux country or the lowland countries. Now coming to next, that is landlocked countries. So landlocked countries are Czech Republic, Hungary. These are the two countries that they are the landlocked countries of Europe. Why? Because they are very far away from the coast and is surrounded by land on all sides. Okay, coming to next, the physical features. So Europe's notable physical features are its peninsular appearance. So as I already told you, Europe looks like peninsula, or it is a peninsula itself. So it's highly indented and irregular coastline. That means Europe has the coastline of Europe is highly indented as well as it is irregular. Now it's not very high altitude, reflecting its old age. So as the height of this continent is less comparative to others, if you compare with Asia, there is a highest peak there, like it reaches up to 8848, and even in some other continent there are highest peak, but here the altitude of this region is very less, because which means that this rocks are of old age found in the continent of Europe. Now physically or physiographically, Europe, the continent of Europe, is divided into four types, you can say. They are the northwestern highland, central plain and central highland, as well as the alpine mountain system. You can look here in this map. Okay, all the physical divisions are given. Okay, here the alpine mountain systems, okay, central highlands, etc. So every physical features are given in this map. Okay, so rest will continue in the next class then.